A new report that was just released shows that Washington State saw a dramatic increase in the number of murders in 2020.
Not only that, but the state ranks last in the country in the number of police officers in the community. KOMO's Keith Eldridge is live with these startling numbers. Keith.
Yeah, it's not looking good. And community and law enforcement leaders say there is every reason to believe that the high crime rate number is directly tied to the low police numbers. No doubt about it. 2020 was a year like no other, with the pandemic, protests, and personal tragedies. There was a dramatic increase in murders in 2020.
To overuse a word that everyone's used too much, it's an unprecedented year. Lockdowns, economic stress, behavioral health issues, other demands on law enforcement and first responders.
The Washington Association of Sheriffs and Police Chiefs just published crime statistics report shows 302 murders in 2020. That's up 46% from the previous year. Another pandemic-related crime, fraud, mostly unemployment claims fraud, was up 131%. Hate crimes are actually down 13%, and assaults on police officers were up 6%.
This year, we've also seen this, you know, increase in homicides. We've seen this increase in the amount of people being shot. Like, and I want to make sure that I put as many resources, but when I lost as many officers as I did last year and then into this year, it really has impacted our ability to be just responding to just basic 911 calls.
When you look around the country, Washington, D.C. ranks first in the amount of police staffing per 1,000 population at 5.99 officers. California is way down the list at number 21 with 2.35. Oregon is 50th at 1.53. And there's Washington at 51st when you count Washington, D.C. at 1.45 officers.
How alarming is that to you?
Well, it's very alarming to me, Keith, and I feel it's only going to get worse after the last legislative session when we took some vital tools away from law enforcement.
The effort now is to reverse the trend, with the Criminal Justice Training Commission resuming full classes after being limited by the pandemic. And coming up tonight at 6 o'clock, how being ranked last in the country is not only affecting or responding to 911 calls, but also limits their ability in another key crime-fighting tool. Reporting live, Keith Eldridge, KOMO News.